Hello learners, you are always eager to learn new things and so am I. Today I am going to show you how you can create custom fabrics in Clo3D. This will allow you to change the appearance and feel of your fabric. So let's dive right in. First, I want to tell you about this amazing kit that lets you create 3D prototype of your fabrics. It has all the details you need to make realistic fabrics. You can watch a video that explains everything about it. The link is in the top right corner or in the description. I recommend you to watch it if you want to work professionally in the future. You can also buy it, but you have to contact Clo directly for that. This is for the advanced user, but you can also change the fabric properties with some basic knowledge. It won't give you an exact replica of your fabric, but it will help you to adjust it to your needs. To access the fabric properties, you have to select your fabric swatch from the object browser and scroll down in the property editor. At the bottom, you will see a section called Physical Property and under that, Details. Expand that section and there you go. You can change each aspect of your fabric as you wish. I will explain them one by one. But before that, let me introduce you to some basic terms. Weft, warp, and bias. In some places, you might also see shear. But that's for adjusting bias only. In any fabric, the length is the warp and the width is weft, and the diagonal is where the bias line lies. To change these values, we have separate slider for different scenarios. First, we have stretch. This determines how much our fabric stretches in horizontal, vertical, and diagonal direction, and how much it resists stretching. To demonstrate it, I will set its vertical value to 0. You can only see the result after simulation. Now it stretches like silk or the jersey fabric. By selecting it back to 27, our fabric will regain its shape. This means that the lower value makes our fabric more elastic. Changing the weft value won't make much difference because it's against the gravity. But you can notice some change near the corners of the fabric. Shear value works with the opposite logic but does the same thing. It controls elasticity resistance. Next topic is bending. This determines how much our fabric folds when it falls. Higher value makes our fabric look like denim or leather. Lower value make it look like silk or jersey. That's why we have placed our fabric over a pearl shape. I have a weft at 100 and the rest bend values at 0. That's why two opposite sides are slightly up and the other two sides are closer to the ground. By setting them all to 0, it will come like a silk again. Next is buckling ratio. This determines how well our fabric holds its shape. Lower value makes our fabric more rigid and vice versa. To show you the effect, I will remove this pearl shape. Our garment has fallen to the ground and it's trying to hold its shape. Let me set these values to 0 first. Our simulation is on. Now let me set them to 100. You can see a quick change in the shape retentions of the fabric. Next we have buckling stiffness. This works with the bending value. Let me adjust the fabric in the similar position as we had the image. By sliding it, we can't make our fabric more stiffer than bending value, but we can reduce that by lowering the values. You can see the outcome right on your screen. Next, we have internal dumping. This option helps us during animation time. Higher value makes our fabric less bouncy. Next we have density. It looks similar to bending value, but it's not. It affects how heavy our fabric is and how much it sags under gravity. Lower value makes our fabric lighter and more airy. Finally, we have friction determines how much our fabric rubs against other fabric or the avatar. Higher value make our fabric more grippy and less slippery. Lower value makes it more smooth and gliding. You can play with these values to create different effects and texture. And that's it. You have learned the basic of the fabric properties in Cloth 3D. You can now change them to suit your need and preference. But remember, if you want to get the realistic result, you need to get a professional kit that helps to take all the details and measurement of real fabric. You can find the link of that below. I hope you enjoyed this lesson and learned something new and fun. If you did, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel for more tutorials and tips. See you in the next class. Until then, keep creating and have fun. Bye!